in 2013, the American Medical Association said obesity is a disease. But the fact that they said, or any of us say, that obesity is a disease doesn't mean that that translated to actually treating it as a disease. Obesity is often viewed as a personal choice, as a disease of behavior. There's an incredible amount of bias and stigma for individuals who have obesity within society, within the healthcare system.
The thing that I don't think we talk about with bias in general is that we come to believe it and internalize it.
Buying into those narratives of, you know, I'm not worthy, I shouldn't be here, I shouldn't be taking up space, I shouldn't, you know, make any trouble. Mentally, it takes a toll on you because you're not really living your life. You're living your life in avoidance of things.
Understanding how a patient walks into your room is critical to consider in the conversation that you're having, because you're gonna have to work a little harder to be able to deliver care, because they have subconsciously believed for a very long time that they weren't deserving of care.
The first time patients come to see me, a lot of them tell me that they almost did not come to the appointment. The thing that they fear the most is that they would be hearing the same thing that they've been hearing for a long time. You really should be trying harder.
When I would go back to a doctor, it was just assumed I hadn't tried or I didn't do it right. We didn't have a conversation of listening to me and saying what I tried or what I didn't think worked. If you want patients to feel empowered and feel motivated, we have to be part of the decision. I think that type of approach is what will work best to get people to come back or to get follow-up screenings. To know their doctors actually do care about them helps them care about themselves.
In that conversation, an important aspect of it is not placing personal blame for obesity. It is that the treatment is failing them. It's not that they are failing the treatment.
In looking at the spectrum of diets from low fat to low carbohydrate to intermittent fasting and everything in between, all of these diets can work. What some of the best research has shown is that the best diet for any given person is the one they find easiest to comply with. But if that doesn't work, what's someone to do?
We need something that actually changes the set point itself. And sometimes medications help with that, and sometimes surgery helps with that.